The lazy initialization exception is one of the most common exceptions when working with Hibernate. There are a few easy ways to fix it, but unfortunately, you can also find lots of bad advice online. The proclaimed fixes often replace the exception with a hidden problem that will cause trouble in production. Some of them introduce performance issues, and others might create inconsistent results. Hi, I'm Torben Jansen, and in this video, I will explain what the lazy initialization exception is, which advice you should ignore, and how to fix the exception instead. But before we proceed, if you're new here and want to learn how to build incredible efficient persistence layers with JPA and Hibernate, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Hibernate throws the lazy initialization exception when it needs to initialize a lazily fetched association to another entity without an active session context. That's usually the case if you try to use an uninitialized association in your client application or web layer. Here you can see a test case with a simplified example. The database query returns an author entity with a lazily fetched association to the books this author has written. Hibernate initializes the books attributes with its own list implementation, which handles the lazy loading. When you try to access an element in that list or call a method that operates on its elements, Hibernate's list implementation recognizes that no active session is available and throws a lazy initialization exception. As I said at the beginning, you can find lots of bad advice on how to fix the lazy initialization exception. Let me quickly explain which suggestions you should ignore. Some developers suggest changing the fetch type of the association to eager. This of course fixes the lazy initialization exception, but it introduces performance problems that will show up in production. When you set the fetch type to eager, Hibernate will always fetch the association, even if you don't use it in your use case. That obviously causes an overhead that slows down your application. But it gets even worse if you don't use the entity manager find method and don't reference the association in a join fetch clause. Hibernate then executes an additional query to fetch the association. This often resides in the N+1 select issue, which is the most common cause of performance issues. So please don't use fetch type eager. As explained in various articles on my blog and in videos on this channel, you should always prefer fetch type lazy. When using the open session in view entity pattern, you open and close the entity manager or Hibernate session in your view layer. You then call the service layer, which opens and commits a database transaction. Because the session is still open after the service layer returned the entity, the view layer can then initialize the lazily fetched association. But after the service layer committed the database transaction, there is no active transaction. Because of that, Hibernate executes each SQL statement triggered by the view layer in auto-commit mode. This increases the load on the database server because it has to handle an extra transaction for each SQL statement. At the end of each of these transactions, the database has to write the transaction log to the disk, which is an expensive operation. The increased pressure on your database isn't the only downside of this anti-pattern. It can also produce inconsistent results because you are now using two or even more independent transactions. As a result, the lazily fetched association might return different data than your service layer used to perform the business logic. Your view layer then presents both information together, and it might seem like your application manages inconsistent data. Unfortunately, Spring Boot uses the open session in view entity pattern by default. It only logs a warning message. You can deactivate it by setting the spring.jpa.openInView parameter in your application.properties file to false. Okay, so what should you do instead? The right way to fix a lazy initialization exception is to fetch all required associations within your service layer. The best option for that is to load the entity with all required associations in one query. Or you can use a DTO projection, which doesn't support lazy loading and needs to be fully initialized before you return it to the client. Let's take a closer look at the different options to initialize lazily fetched associations and at the best way to use DTO projections. The easiest way to load an entity with all required associations is to perform a JPQL or criteria query with one or more left join fetch clauses. that tells Hibernate to not only fetch the entity referenced in the projection, but also to fetch all associated entities referenced in the left join fetch clause. Here you can see a simple example of such a query. The query selects author entities, and the left join fetch clause tells Hibernate to also fetch the associated book entities. As you can see in the generated SQA statement, Hibernate not only joins the two corresponding tables in the from clause, it also added all columns mapped by the book entity to the select clause. As you can see in the log messages, the query returned an author entity with an initialized book association. You can do the same using a named entity graph. The main difference is that the definition of the graph is independent of the query. That enables you to use the same query with different graphs or to use the same graph with various queries. I explained named entity graphs in great detail in a previous video, so I keep the explanation short. You can define the graph by annotating one of your entity classes with a named entity graph annotation. Within this annotation, you can provide multiple named attribute node annotations to specify the attributes that Hibernate shall fetch. To use this graph, you first need to get a reference to it from your entity manager. In the next step, you can set it as a hint on your query. If you look at the generated SQA statement, you can see that there is no difference between a left join fetch clause and a named entity graph. Both approaches result in a query that selects all columns mapped by the author and the book entity, and return an author entity with an initialized books association. The entity graph API provides you the same functionality as the named entity graph annotation. The only difference is that you use a Java API instead of annotations to define the graph. That enables you to adjust the graph definition dynamically. As you can see in the code, the API-based definition of the graph follows the same concepts as the annotation-based definition. You first create the graph by calling the createEntityGraph method. In the next step, you can add multiple attribute nodes and subgraphs to the graph. I explain all of that in great detail in JPA Entity Graphs, how to dynamically define and use an entity graph. After you define the graph, you can use it in the same way as a named entity graph, and Hibernate generates an identical query for both of them. Fetching all required associations when you load the entity fixes the lazy initialization exception. But there's an alternative that's an even better fit for all read operations. As I showed in a previous article, DTO projections provide significantly better performance if you don't want to change the retrieved information. In these situations, you can use a constructor expression to tell Hibernate to instantiate a DTO object for each record in the result set. Hibernate then generates an SQA statement that only selects the columns that are mapped by the attributes that you reference in the constructor call. This often reduces the number of selected columns and improves the performance even further. If you have used Hibernate for a while, you probably had to fix at least one lazy initialization exception. It's one of the most common ones when working with Hibernate. As I explained in this video, you can find lots of advice online on how to fix this exception. But a lot of these suggestions only replace the exception with problems that will show up in production. There are only two good solutions to this problem. You initialize all required associations when you load the entity using a left join fetch clause or a named entity graph or the entity graph API. Or you use a DTO projection instead of entities. DTOs don't support lazy loading, and you need to fetch all required information within your service layer. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!